Hello viewers, today we are going to see about moving coil galvanometer. Basically a galvanometer is basically used to measure very small current in the order of 10 microamps, 20 microamps, like that. So we have two types of meters, one is moving coil, another one is moving iron meters. Okay, so in moving coil, the coil will move, whereas in moving iron, the soft iron core will move. That's the difference. So in your syllabus we have a moving coil meter. So in the moving coil meter, what we have is there will be a permanent magnet, so magnetic field is established, and in between the magnetic field, steady magnetic field, you have a coil suspended, and over the top of the coil you have a pointer with some balancing arrangement, mechanical balancing arrangement, so that it produces deflection. So already we know the current, the magnetic field and the force are all mutually perpendicular to each other. So current, by thumb rule, we can always find out current flowing this side means magnetic field will be in this direction. So these two are mutually perpendicular to each other, and the force is, all the three are mutually perpendicular to each other. That means we have current, therefore magnetic field, and therefore force. So we are making use of that force to make the needle deflect and see what's the current flowing through the coil. So that's the idea. So let me see through the diagram. So moving coil galvanometer, this is north pole, south pole. You have a coil, see these lines are coil, that is the coil will be like this. So I am showing a big one. Okay, this is a core, soft iron core. Over this the coil is wound. You should imagine, right? This is soft iron core, it is cylindrical in nature, over which this coil is wound. Okay, and we have some balancing arrangement at the bottom as well as on the top. Now this is suspended, this entire thing is suspended in a constant magnetic field, that's what is shown here. Okay, and we have some spring attachment. So this is soft iron core. So in moving coil, what happens is we are winding this coil. Now this coil will rotate over the soft iron core, in that case it is moving coil. Now coil is fixed, and the core, if the core, soft iron core is moving, then it becomes moving iron instrument. That is one major difference. Now you have to visualize. So the coil is wound on the soft iron core. Why we use soft iron core? To increase the magnetic flux density. Okay, so on top of it, the needle will, when the current flows through the coil, already a constant magnetic field, therefore force is experienced, therefore the needle will deflect. And beneath the needle we have a mirror, so that to avoid parallax error. Okay, right. So we have north pole, south pole. You have a spring to balance the, to give a counter torque. Okay, you have a coil, you can see the coil. Actually this is a top view, therefore you will see only as a straight line. Actually the, over the soft iron core it is wounded. Okay, so this is soft iron core, and we have a uniform radial magnetic field. So the, because actually if you see, it will be like this. The magnet is, it is not flat, it is curved. Inside you have this soft iron core, assume a cylindrical circle. So all are in the radial direction, the magnetic field is in radial direction, and it is uniform field. Okay, right. So the torque produced, the deflecting torque produced, depends on number of turns. If you increase the number of turns, then torque will increase. The current, of course, current increases, torque increases. Area of the coil, the length and breadth of the coil. Okay, if it is small, area is small, means small deflection. If it is a big one, then there is a big deflection. Then magnetic flux density. So magnetic flux density means between north and south pole, the power of the magnetic field that you are establishing between north and south pole on the coil. So it depends on these factors. The torque produced depends on number of turns, current through the coil, area of the coil, and then magnetic flux density. So if If all the parameters is increasing, naturally torque is also increasing. But certain things are constant. How, why? After manufactured a moving coil instrument, the number of turns cannot be altered, area cannot be altered, magnetic flux density cannot be altered, because it has been assembled and the product has come out. The only option we have in our hand is the current through the coil. So by varying the current, current increases, torque also increases, current decreases, torque also decreases. So for us, the design parameter we have is only the current, all other are manufactured and it is ready, we cannot alter anything, right? Now the needle will from zero it will start moving, right? When there is no current, it comes to zero. So when it is moving, there should not be any jittering, and that you must apply a counter torque, therefore it is balanced there, okay? So the counter torque produced is K pi, which is NIAB, where K is torsional constant. Torsional constant. So K phi, phi is the deflection angle, is equal to NIAB. Okay, so the phi is NAB by K into I. So this is the counter torque. So when a current is passed, the needle will deflect, and to balance that torque, we have to give counter torque. And the counter torque is given by K phi, which is NIAB. Okay, now, so phi is the deflecting angle. Okay. Now generally, if you purchase a moving coil galvanometer or moving coil instrument in general, the galvanometer current is roughly around 20 microamps, 50 microamps, less than 50 microamps. That means if it's 20 microamps, means it is highly sensitive. If it is 5 microamps, means it is still highly sensitive instrument. So you have to handle these instruments with great care. Now we have to define current sensitivity. What is the minimum current it can read out? That is deflection per unit current. So what you do is, now pi by I, that means you bring this I this side, the deflection angle per unit current is equal, that is current sensitivity, which is NAB by K. Okay, similarly for voltage sensitivity, phi by V, that means this equation divided by V, both left hand side and right hand side you are dividing by V. Now you have I by V. I by V can be written as 1 divided by V by I, that is nothing but this is resistance. That is, the resistance of the coil increases, then the voltage sensitivity decreases. Okay, that's the key point you have to remember. So to improve the current sensitivity, we must have minimum resistance of the coil. We have to choose a material such that the resistance is very minimal, so that voltage sensitivity is improved. So you cannot equate a current sensitivity and voltage sensitivity, both will not be equal. This has a different formula and this has different formula. Right. So that's all about moving coil galvanometer. This finds frequent use in measuring instruments. We can, based on this galvanometer, we can build a ammeter, voltmeter, ohmmeter. Okay, anything can be built, and everything put in a single unit, we call it as a multimeter. So this is a basic instrument, and it usually it is used in the laboratories. Nowadays, this has been replaced by digital meters, but still this is being used in the field right now. Hope you have understood this topic about moving coil galvanometer. Thanks for watching. Nandri.